فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Such as the hadith which is very known is the hadith of Anas ibn Malik. This hadith is mashhur bayn ahli al-hadith, very known amongst the people of hadith. Which is the hadith of Anas ibn Malik where he says, أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ قَنَتَ شَهْرًا بَعْدَ الرُّكُوعِ يَدْعُ إِلَى رِعْلٍ وَذَكْوَانٍ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he prayed for a whole month, making dua against Ri'l and Dhakwan, those two tribes. The second one is what is mashhur, it is mashhur, famous amongst the people of hadith and the normal ulama and the general mass. It's well known amongst everyone. And that is the hadith which is al-muslimu man salima al-muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadi. The believer is the one that the believers are safe from his tongue and his hand. There's a hadith which is very famous and is very famous from the ulama of fiqh. Third time. It's very famous from the ulama of fiqh. It is the hadith which is abghadul halali ila Allah at-talaqu. The thing that is most hated to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is what? It is halal. This hadith is munkar. This hadith is munkar. So that hadith is very famous. If you look at the fuqaha, they tend to use that hadith. It's very common amongst them. The next one is the fourth type, right? It is the hadith that's very common amongst the usuliyin, very common amongst them, which is, huh? It's the hadith, رُفِعَ عَنْ أُمَّتِي الْخَطَأُ وَالنِّسْيَانُ وَمَا اسْتُكْرِهَ عَلَيْهِ. That it has been lifted from my nation, mistakes, forgetfulness, and that which they have been burdened on. That hadith, usuliyin, they tend to use it a lot. It's famous amongst them, very famous, because they base a lot of ruling on it. The hadith which is very famous amongst the general mass, they all tend to use a lot, is al-ajalatu min shaytan. Hastiness is from shaytan. Al-ajalatu min shaytan, people tend to use that. Brothers, the hadith which is mashhur, which is the ahad, brothers, pay attention. Its ruling is based upon whether it fulfills the conditions of authenticity, which we will come to later. The mutawatir, do we do that? Yeah. No, mutawatir does not go through observation in its authenticity or not. Once it has become clear to us that it's mutawatir and it fulfilled the criteria of being a mutawatir, there's no research required after that. Huh? Its authenticity is clear. Yeah. And the hadith which is ahad, and we've taken the first type of ahad which is mashur, it falls under observation. It can be sahih. The hadith which is ahad, it can be sahih. It can be hasan and it can be da'if. And it also can be mawdu, fabricated. So that number can be fabricated. What are the famous books that are written on the books of Mashhur? If I wanted to go and look at books of hadith of Mashhur. It is the kitab Al-Maqasid Al-Hasana. Al-Maqasid Al-Hasana. Fima Ishtahara Ala Al-Sinati. That book is written by Shamsuddin Al-Sakhawi, the student of Ibn Hajar, rahimahullahu ta'ala. The second book is Kashf Al-Khafai Wa Muzil Al-Ilbasi. فيما اشتهر من الحديث على ألسنة الناس للعجلوني. عجلوني wrote it, رحمه الله. The third book is تمييز الطيب من الخبيث فيما يدور على ألسنة الناس من الحديث. And this is written by تمييز الطيب من الخبيث is written by Ibn al-Dabi'i al-Shaybani. Naam. Al-Azizu. We're now going to take Al-Aziz. So we've just finished Al-Mashhur. We've taken what Mashhur means linguistically and technically. Technically, linguistically we said it means هو اسم مفعول من شهرت الأمر إذا أعلنته وأظهرته وسمي بذلك لظهوري. It is anything that becomes famous and known. Technically, it means ما رواه ثلاثة فأكثر. It is anything that three or more narrated. في كل طبقة in all of its stages, its levels. ما لم يبلغ حد التواتر. As long as it does not reach the level of تواتر. And we said, according to some of the ulama, the تواتر is 10. So as long as it doesn't reach 10. Now we're going to swiftly move on to the second type of had, which is aziz. What does aziz mean? هو صفة مشبهة. And we have to know what the word aziz is from. Then we can know what is meant by it technically, or why it's called aziz. Aziz is from the word azza. The fi'l mudari' becomes what? Ya'izu bikasri al-'ayni. Pay attention. Azza, you will say if it's the madi, the mudari' you say ya'izu. Pay attention. Which is kasra on the 'ayn. That when it becomes izzu, what does that mean? Qalla wa nadara. When it becomes little and rare. When it's bikasri al-'ayni on the fi'l mudari'. Azza ya'izu. This becomes qalla wa nadar. It's little and it's rare. So that's the first reason why it's called aziz. Because it's rare. It's little that you find aziz. The second one is that the word is rooted from the word azza ya'azzu. Ya'azzu. Bifathi al-ka'ayn. The ayn has a fatha on it. It has a fatha on it. That when it becomes ya'azzu, what does it mean? قوية واشتد. It became strong. It became strong. Why would it be used for that meaning? Because if it's not aziz, it's what? It's gharib, right? This chain helped it, supported it, strengthened it. Does that make sense? It's an additional chain. That came, it strengthened it. That's what it means linguistically. What does it mean technically? أَلَّا يَقِلَّ الرُّوَاتُ. It is that the narrators are not less than two. They're not less than two. في جميع الطبقات السند. In the what? In the chain of narration. Are you all with me? Now pay attention, brothers. I really want you to understand and ponder. Here we defined it with saying what? It should not be less than two. Can it be more than that? Yes, it can. It can be. It can be 200 that narrated here, and then 200, and in one place, two narrated, it becomes aziz, no problem. It can be more if it wants in the chain of narration. But if we find within the tabaqat, in the stages, one time, that it's two, this is the strongest view that it's aziz. So 20 people narrated from the Prophet. But from those 20 that narrated from Prophet, only two people took it from those 20 people. It would have been what? Mutawatir. Now it became aziz. And that's the goal Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he strengthened in that definition. He chose that definition. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah. He said, rahimahullah, that it has to be riwayat al-thunayn aw thalathatin. He said that it's the chain of narration of two or three. Ibn Hajar said three, if he narrates it, it's still aziz. Hajar said, no problem. Because why? Allah said in the Quran, فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ. فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ. That is if three. As for two, وَجَعَلِّي وَزِيرًا مِّنْ أَهْلِي. Oh Allah, make a wazir for my family. So they say that these two are showing two and three. That is the definition of it. What is an example of it? An example of it is what is narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. Pay attention. Bukhari and Muslim, both of them narrated from who? Anas ibn Malik. Bukhari and Muslim, both of them narrated from who? Anas ibn Malik. But Bukhari also narrated by himself, from Abu Huraira. Are you with me? So how many companions do we have? Two. Bukhari and Muslim together, who do they narrate from? Anas. Abu Huraira, Bukhari narrated from him alone. Are you with me? Anas, how many people narrated from him? Are you with me? Two people narrated from Anas. Qatada and Abd al-Aziz ibn al-Suhayb. Qatada and Abd al-Aziz ibn al-Suhayb. In the second tabaqa, how many people do we have? Two. So tabaqa is working, no problem. How many people narrated from Qatada? Two people. Shu'bah. Are you with me? and Sa'id ibn Abi Aruba. Or, according to some of the ulama, it's not Sa'id ibn Abi Aruba, it is Sa'id ibn Bashir. Whichever one. The Qatada, those two people narrated from him. Abdul Aziz ibn Suhaib, how many people narrated from him? Abdul Aziz ibn Suhaib, who narrated from him? Ismail ibn Ulayyah and Abdul Warith. Are you all with me? So Abdul Aziz narrated from two people, Ismail ibn Ulayyah, one, and the second one is Abdul Warith. Now, the top chain of narration, how many Sahabas? Two. How many Tabi'un? Two. How many Atba'u Tabi'in? No. Four. The hadith is what? The minimum. Two. It's Aziz. The hadith is what? The hadith is Aziz. Ibn Hajar refutes something now here. Pay attention. He says, وَلَيْسَ شَرْطًا لِلصَّحِيحِ خِلَافًا لِمَنْ زَعْمَهُ. Aziz, huh, is not a condition for authenticity opposite to the one who claims it. He's refuting the one who claims it. So before we move into that point, we have to mention, again, the ruling of Aziz is what, brothers? The ruling of Aziz is that it can be sahih, it can be da'if, and it can be hasan, no problem. As I said again, and I'm going to repeat, the hadith which is ahad, huh? We look at it either as maqbool or mardood. It's either accepted or rejected. The hadith which is what? Mutawatir does not go into that. So Aziz is the second type of ahad, right? So it can be sahih, it can be hasan, and it can be da'if. Pay attention. Ibn Hajar now is refuting a group of people. What's he saying? There were some people who conditioned for hadith to be authentic for it to be Aziz. That's what they said. So what did they say? The minimum has to be two. Who is those who condition authenticity to be? Huh? Al-Imam al-Hakim, Abu Abdillahi. Al-Imam al-Hakim in Saburi. In his Kitab al-Ma'rifa, he conditioned that authenticity. He said for hadith to be authentic, it has to be how many? Are you all with me? And brothers, pay attention. Abu Abdullah Hakim ibn Nisabur, are you all with me? Mm-hmm. Are you with me?
Yeah.
He is the sheikh, the imam, who done istidrakat on Bukhari Muslim. Meaning, a hadith which Bukhari Muslim, there it was there, conditions, he came and he brought them and said, look, these also were his conditions. Bukhari, he never narrated them. These are also his conditions, he never narrated them. And these are also his conditions, he never narrated it. Do you see my point? Because Hakim and Naysaburi, his belief of the hadith to be authentic is based upon it to be Aziz, at least minimum. Would he get it wrong when he does the istidrakat on Bukhari? Of course he's going to be getting it wrong. Of course he's going to force on Bukhari conditions that are not his conditions. Because he's saying that the hadith to be authentic, it has to be how many? Two. And is that the reality of Bukhari's conditions? We're going to come to it, inshallah. Ibn al-Arabi, in his A'radatul Ahwadi, and al-Karmani in Sharh al-Bukhari, they said no. What did they say? They said no. Aziz is not a condition for what? Pay attention, brothers. The first person was who? Hakim al-Naysaburi, Abu Abdullah Hakim al-Naysaburi, he said that for a hadith to be sahih originally, for us to say that this hadith is sahih, it has to be what? At least Aziz. And then onwards. Are you with me? Who came after him and refuted him? Ibn al-Arabi. Al-Mu'arraf bil-Alif wal-Lam. Pay attention. I said al-Arabi. If he's not Mu'arraf, if he's not Alif al-Lam, then he's the one that said Muhyiddin al-Arabi. He's not Mu'arraf, he's Nakira. He's a fasiq, mujrim, kafir. This one is the Mu'arraf, the great Maliki scholar. A'radatul Ahwadi, look what he said, Ibn al-Arabi. And al-Karmani, they refuted who? Abu Abdullah al-Naysaburi, they said, you're wrong. They said that hadith can be sahih without it being Aziz. Of course it can be. But they went on to another mistake. What did they say? They said that what you're saying is the condition of Bukhari only. For a hadith to be sahih according to Bukhari, it has to be Aziz. But they said that there can be a hadith which is not aziz, it means gharib, and it's sahih, it can be, they said. But what you're saying, Hakim, is that this is the condition of Bukhari, faqat. Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, he refutes them. All of them. In his Fathul Bari, the Sharh Sahih al-Bukhari, what did he say? He says that this claim of theirs is rejected by the first hadith Bukhari opens with. إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ refutes them. And also the hadith of Kalimatani, which is the last hadith. Kalimatani khafifatani ala lisani. It is as though, brothers, pay attention, that Bukhari is telling the people Ahad is accepted from the beginning and the end. He opened his book with a hadith which is Ahad, and he closed his book with a hadith which is, and we're not talking about Ahad only, hadith which is gharib, which is lower than Aziz. For example, the first one, which is the first hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Umar is the only one who narrated from the Prophet. The only person who narrated from the Prophet is who? We don't say it is the only person who heard it from the Prophet. Don't say that. That is wrong. Because others could have heard it from the Prophet. But we will say the only person who narrated it from the Prophet is who? Umar ibn al-Khattab. Who, the only person who narrated from Umar, even though he read it in a Friday congregation, in a khutbatul jum'ah, on the pulpit. Hayya? Even then, only one person narrated from Umar. Alqamah ibn Waqas al-Laythi. No one narrated from Alqamah ibn Abi Waqas al-Laythi except Muhammad ibn Ibrahim. And no one narrated from Muhammad ibn Ibrahim except Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. After Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari, the hadith became what? That's where Humaydi Abdullah ibn Zubayr comes in, Sufyan comes in, Abdullah ibn Mubarak came in. Many people narrated after that. Then it reached 200, as Ibn Hajar, Ibn Rajab mentions, 200. From who? After Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari, it became 200. Pay attention. Like this hadith is gharib, aslan. All of the tabaqat of the sanad is gharib. Are you all with me? All the tabaqat of the sanad is gharib. The second hadith, which is the one, kalimatani khafifatani ala lisani. This is narrated from Abu Hurairah. No one narrated it. Abu Hurairah is the only person who has narrated it to us from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And no one else narrated it from Abu Hurairah except Abu Zur'ah, Ibn Amr, Ibn Jarir al-Bajali. And the only person who narrated it from Abu Zur'ah, Ibn Amr, Ibn Jarir al-Bajali is Ammarah, Ibn al-Qa'qa. And no one narrated it to us from Ammarah ibn al-Qa'qa, except Muhammad ibn Fudayl, and after Muhammad ibn Fudayl, the hadith became large in number. So the hadith, so it goes against that Bukhari. This is, so it's the two groups are wrong. Abdullah Hakim and Naysaburi is wrong by saying what? That the authentic, for a hadith to be authentic, it has to be ghari and aziz minimum. Hada qawlu mardud. It's a rejected view. And also Ibn al-Arabi, and also Al-Karmani, both of them are also rejected views to say that no, they refuted Abu Abdullah and Naysaburi and said, look, you're wrong. Of course, the hadith can be sahih without it being aziz. But then they said that these conditions of who? Al-Bukhari, they are also wrong because these two hadiths are against them. And that's where San'ani rahimahullah, he said, وَلَيْسَ شَرْطًا لِلصَّحِيحِ فَعَلَمِي وَقَدْ رُومِي مَنْ قَالَ بِالتَّوَهُمِ. And some of the nusakh, some of the publication, rather it says, وَلَيْسَ شَرْطًا لِلصَّحِيحِ فَعْلَمِي وَقِيلَ شَرْطٌ وَهُوَ قَوْلُ الْحَاكِمِ. Some of the manuscripts, that's what it says. وَالرَّابِعُ, the fourth type is الْغَرِيبُ. The fourth type, or meaning the third type of ahad. The third type of ahad, and here what he means is the fourth type of the khabar. The khabar is how many types? Four. Mutawatir. And the three types of what? The three types of ahad. So, al-mashhur, al-aziz, and al-gharib. Four, sah? It's four types. But we're saying that the ahad is three types. Pay attention. Gharib is the last one. What does it mean linguistically? هو صفة مشبهة أولا. بمعنى المنفرد. It is the one that's singular. Also, the word gharib linguistically means al-ba'idu an aqaribih. The person who is far from his relatives, his family members. He's called a gharib. He's a stranger. So strange. اصطلاحا technically it means ما رما ينفرد بروايته راو واحد. It is that which one narrator is singular in narrating, translating it. Just one person narrates it. And that what? It doesn't matter if it's all of, it does not matter if it's in all of the chain of narrations. If it occurs once in the chain of narration, in any of the tabaqah, it's gharib.